It's mid-October here in Vermont and the leaves are changing, and I just wanted to show you a really neat way during this time of year that you can tell where different tree species are from miles away. The leaves of many of our hardwood deciduous trees change colors in different ways. And so for this brief moment in time, you can actually see where these different species of trees are located by the color of their leaves. Different individual trees will do this differently. So sometimes you'll get an oddball tree that's not really doing what its species is supposed to be doing as far as its leaves changing color. But for the most part, these are pretty good rules. First one to tune into is red maple. Red maple leaves turn bright red. There's the red of a red maple leaf. The second one to tune into is sugar maple. Sugar maple leaves will be orange. Here's the orange of a sugar maple leaf. The other one to keep an eye out for is red oak. The thing that's distinctive about red oak is that it actually doesn't change color till much later than the other tree species around here. So when you look up into the mountains and you see these reds, oranges, yellows, you'll also see these pockets of green, and those green are pockets of oak. It can actually be really useful if you're a deer hunter to locate areas where there's oak, which means there might be acorns, which means there might be more deer hanging out in that area. When oak finally does change color, you'll see it turns into this sort of rusty auburn brown after all of the other trees have already lost their leaves. Seeing the color yellow is much less diagnostic than seeing the green of the oak, or the red of the red maple, or the orange of the sugar maple. There's a bunch of different tree species whose leaves turn yellow. The biggest ones though will be beech, which will turn sort of this coppery yellow color. Here's the sort of coppery yellow of a beech leaf, and yellow birch, which will turn this straight up yellow. You can usually tell where white ash is because their leaves tend to be more of a purplish yellow color and because they drop sooner. So right now, even though most of the other hardwood species still have most of their leaves, the ash trees have already lost all their leaves. I can tell where they are just by looking and seeing the areas where there's trees with no leaves. Besides just being another way to identify the trees in the forest, it can actually be really exciting to be able to do this sort of dendrology from a distance because of the story that it tells about our landscape. If you know what to look for, you can actually tell a lot about what's going on with soils, aspect, and topography just by looking at the tree species that are growing there. So for instance, red oak, red maple, and beech are species that tend to grow on drier, more well-drained, more acidic soils, and you'll see them on those south-facing slopes. Sugar maple tends to do better on cooler, richer, more moist soils, and so you'll see them on north-facing slopes. Here in the Winooski River Valley, we have these soils on lower elevations that were largely created by sand and gravel deposits from glaciers and glacial lakes. And on those sands and gravels, which are more well-drained, more acidic, drier, you'll see those species, the beech, the red maple, the red oak, growing. As soon as we get above those soils, which here is at 600 feet in elevation, you'll see the green of the red oak and the red of the red maple and that coppery yellow of the beech transition to the orange of sugar maple and the yellow of yellow birch.